Hey guys, I just want you to have a little noise for his video. Usually it's just so quiet, it's real nice and peaceful. So I figured I would jump on here and just be like, ah!
What you doing, Jess?
Moving stuff.
Planting.
Getting ready, babe.
feel like you can do something with that.
With the snow? Lovely. Well, I know we can also let the seeds fall.
Yeah. So are the seeds ripe in there?
I don't know. I mean, eventually there will be. We can go ahead and bring out a bit more flowers.
There might be. Hmm. It must smell like fennel almost.
I know.
Look at the seed. The seed almost looked like it.
I wonder if they're related. The leaves are very carroty.
Yeah.
Now I gotta Google it.
Did you see that video of that girl that got a marigold seed stuck in her teeth?
No.
She was eating salad, or in her gum.
Exactly what I do is just like make a little mash point with the board. Because essentially, like, this is what you're doing to cover it with soil.
Yeah.
And so with these that are old, I would go pretty thick on that. With the newer seeds, you can try to space it out more. But they're just going to be flat on top of the flat soil.
Mm-hmm.
And then where the board just sets on top of them, and it'll hold this moisture. And then we probably need to start checking in like 4 or 5 days because it's so warm.
Are the seeds supposed to be?
Oh, those are pelleted, so that makes them a little bit easier to space.
Okay.
So those are just coated. Johnny's does that with some of theirs to help make spacing easier.
Yeah.
But since those have been sitting in the greenhouse, carrot seeds don't really like getting hot.
Mm-hmm.
So it might affect the germination.
Do you ever lift up the boards and water them? Or you just...
So humid.
Yeah.
I think that helps. I mean, you could lift up the boards and check, but I don't think that they'll need it.
Yeah.
Now, you can water over the boards, and that way the soil will soak it up.
Yeah.
Like, it, you know, they'll get rained on and stuff. That keeps the seeds from washing away, so...
Just so y'all know, I didn't mean to break off the stems like this. I just don't have my knife on me. So we might have to eat these fairly soon. And I also normally would wait. And I am waiting to pick some of these until the first frost comes. They're going to be a lot sweeter then. but I need to cut the grass right there. So I picked them.
Check this out, y'all.
Neighbor has a chestnut tree. And for some reason, a lot of people don't like chestnuts, but I love them. So we're gonna take these inside and we're gonna roast them. My payment for the chestnuts, I collect the spiky balls that come off of them. Be careful with these things, they will stab your hands. But it is a good deal. We're going to roast them and then we're going to plant some. Good stuff. Thank you. I don't know if you have to water this, guys. It's just been really dry here for the past 2 weeks, and there's no rain in the forecast either, so I'm just gonna add a little bit of moisture because I don't want the nuts to dry out. I did this last year and I waited too long to actually do this process, and the nuts had already dried. You could shake them in their shell. That's how you know they're dry. But these are fresh, so they should do better. Thus we will see. Catter, what are you doing? Oh my goodness. Oh, they're going to cut yourself, girl. Grab her.
Can I help you, baby? Can I help you?
She's going to cut herself on that.
Chilly, and it's gonna be 45 degrees tonight.
Not chilly out here.
It's chilly.
You wanna start a fire?
No, it's too warm. You think we should start a fire?
You said no.
I don't know what I want. You should know this. Cold day in October. Lots of firewood stacked. Sun's just gone down. Tops of the trees are kissed with orange.
Kitty's going crazy.
And Kitty's going crazy.
It's the good stuff.
The longer I've waited, the more that I've tried. All the years that I've wasted, trying to find. Blue morning.
Thank you.